knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Over the past few centuries, human civilization has grown exceedingly complex. Unlike the primitive bartering of ancient cultural centers, we now deal with a monstrous global economy, which necessitates the handling and transfer of currency, often via physically intangible forms in this information age. But as abstract as this seems, whether we realize it or not, economics affects us all. So, what does it mean? Upon hearing the word economics, one would certainly think about money, but more specifically, the manner in which wealth is distributed, or perhaps immediately personal and relatable concepts like wages and taxes. Then there are slightly more large-scale concepts like recessions, gross domestic product, and the stock market. However, most of these concepts belong to the realm of macroeconomics, which involves looking at national and global economies. In this series, we will start out with an in-depth survey of microeconomics, which involves studying how economics affects individual decisions, the kind that we all make every day. This will give us the context and foundational knowledge to then expand into macroeconomics, such that all of these larger concepts will suddenly be more relatable. And finally, to wrap up the series, we will look at personal economics, which involves examining how we use economic foundations to navigate our lives. That means we will go over budgeting, bank accounts, and even things like how to use a credit card. But before we get to all of these topics, we have to start at the very beginning, and boiled down to its essence, economics all comes down to choice. For example, if you are watching this video, you made a choice to watch it. Now, it's possible that a teacher may be compelling you to watch this right now, but regardless, someone made a choice. You could be doing 1,000 other things at this moment, like riding a bike, or making tortellini, but out of all of those things, you're here on my channel. First, thanks for watching, of course. And second, the fact that you made the choice to watch this video is a fantastic example for demonstrating what economics is on the fundamental level. Economics is the study of how we make choices based on scarcity. One of the most important concepts in economics is scarcity. Scarcity is a term that simply refers to the fact that we have endless wants and needs, but a limited amount of resources to fulfill those wants and needs. To be clear with our terminology, a resource is anything that is useful to us. This doesn't strictly refer to natural resources like water. This term could refer to your teacher, this video, or the pen and paper you take notes with, presuming that you are taking notes right now like a good student. But regardless of the type of resource, they all have limits. If there was an endless supply of everything, economics would not exist. We are constantly weighing our wants and needs to make choices due to scarcity, and the three most common examples of limited resources are time, money, and energy. For example, let's say that you need to learn economics. Perhaps you don't have the time to watch all of my economics tutorials because you're busy at your job. Perhaps you don't have the money to pay for economics instruction at a university. Or perhaps you don't have the energy or the patience to sit and practice working through many difficult economics problems. The limited amounts of these resources can have an impact on one's ability to fulfill this need of learning economics. To define some more terms, we satisfy our wants and needs with goods and services. Goods are the physical stuff that we produce, like food, clothing, and electronic devices. Services are actions or activities we perform, like delivering food, dry cleaning articles of clothing, and fixing electronic devices. All goods and services are said to be scarce because they are necessarily in limited supply. This is because the resources used to make goods and the time required to perform services are inherently limited. Now, to be clear, scarcity does not specifically refer to a shortage. A shortage occurs when consumers want a larger quantity of a good or service than producers are willing or able to make available at a certain price. Unlike shortages, which are circumstantial, scarcity always exists, simply because resources and humans are not infinite in number. This is why economics will always exist, and since we can't escape it, we'd better learn about it now. Hopefully, we now understand a bit more clearly what the field of economics studies and why it is of such universal concern. Just as with many scientific principles that we interact with every day, whether we are aware of it or not, economics shapes the world we live in and the choices that we make. So together, let's learn all about economics, such that we can better understand why we make the choices that we do and potentially make more informed decisions in the future.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.